What does this say? U.S. government poisoning program during Prohibition, 1926 to 1933. And Lorcan, you've written up in the New York Daily News today. Tell me why.
As you know, we have a speakeasy here from the Prohibition era that is now Theater 80. And it was run by Frank Hoffman, who's one of the leading bootleggers in New York, with Walter Scheib.
Oh, so this is a New York Times archive from 1931, right, about the two men that were bootleggers, and then your family bought Theater 80 from Scheib? Unbelievable. And what's this right here?
This is still, as part of the museum discussing gangsters in New York, we tell the history of compelled labor, human trafficking, alcohol production.
And also government and corruption.
The U.S. government actually had a program to poison industrial alcohol during Prohibition. So, for example, one of the bootleg labels we have says no alcohol added.
Do you want to hold it up and show me?
So that the buyers know that what they're getting is the real stuff, not something that had industrial alcohol added, which killed 10,000 people during Prohibition.
Oh, my God.
The first night, 60 people died in New York from drinking poisoned alcohol, poisoned by the U.S. government.
Unbelievable. I had no idea. So when does your exhibition open? And
the preview is this Sunday, the 7th.
At what time?
At from 12 to 5, hourly tours, and then the actual museum opens on the 15th of March.
Okay, and we'll visit your website and the Daily News article. It's great. Congratulations.
Thank you.